Today, I'll be talking about the four hormones of happiness. Happiness is a very subjective term. The definition keeps changing throughout the day. Sometimes you are a little happy, sometimes you are not happy, sometimes you are unhappy, sometimes you are very happy, elated, sometimes you are more than happy. That's not a term, but yes, you are more than happy because you are not able to express your happiness. You are that happy. So that happiness comes from something that happens in your mind. So those are the four hormones of happiness. I'll be talking about those four hormones. The very first hormone of those is endorphin. Endorphins. Endorphins, our body releases endorphins early in the morning when we do exercises. So that's why it's always recommended to do exercise. Be it for 30 minutes only, but you should always exercise. No matter what, you should do it, because that is the only thing that will keep your endorphin hormone in control. So do not leave exercise at any cost. Then second thing that controls your endorphins level is laughter. Aapne dekha hoga when you do yoga, so there's this particular asana, hasya asana. It's not necessary that you have to actually laugh, but that's sometimes a fake laughter. But that too releases hormones. So laughter is very important. So keep this thing in mind that you'll exercise regularly and you'll laugh regularly. So you can wake up in the morning, do exercises, and then watch a 5 minutes or a 10 minutes comedy thing. You might have noticed back in 2000s and 2000 till 2010, 15, even till 2015, people would send a funny joke early in the morning along with good morning. So there was always an exchange of jokes in the form of messages. So the reason was to control our endorphin levels, to manage those, to keep those balanced. So that is endorphin. And that's why it's very important to keep endorphin under control. So you can do that by doing exercises and by laughing. So you can laugh with me right now as well. Okay, so second hormone is dopamine. You might have heard this term dopamine quite a lot of times. Dopamine is a hormone which is attached with accomplishment. An accomplishment could be a little accomplishment or a big accomplishment. Little like you just wrote an essay and your parents are appreciating you for the essay, or whatever. Like there's a movie which is going on and there's this particular vocabulary term which is spoken in the movie and you are able to answer the meaning. So your parents again appreciate you for doing that. So that is a rise in dopamine level. That is like controlling and managing your dopamine level. So you have to work hard on that. You have to keep learning things. That is the only way of increasing dopamine. And always appreciate people around yourself. Mostly it happens when our mothers cook food. We forget to thank them. For 20 continuous days, we'll say that the food is tasty, the food is good. If by chance she forgets to put salt one day, we'll criticize her. We'll even start shouting. So that is decreasing her dopamine level. So we are not supposed to do that. We have to take the onus, we have to take the responsibility of thanking everybody around ourselves for doing little things. So that will be controlling dopamine. So for dopamine, you have to focus on accomplishments, daily accomplishments. You can make a diary and just tick that, yeah, I have completed this thing, I have completed this thing. Sometimes you must have noticed that people do shopping quite a lot to make themselves happy. That is also increasing dopamine level. Because you end up feeling that if I shop, I look good, people will give me compliments. Even though the compliments are very short-lived, but yes, they are compliments. So that they will also help you in increasing your dopamine level. So that is dopamine. Now coming on to serotonin. Serotonin is the third hormone of happiness. Now what is serotonin? Serotonin is the hormone of giving, act of giving. We have taken a lot from the society, from everyone around ourselves. So now it's our turn to give back to society. Even sharing knowledge is controlling serotonin. Like there's a term KT. My husband uses this term quite a lot. KT. It means knowledge transfer. You must have heard this quotation that Vidya ek akela dhan hai, ek aisa dhan hai, jo sirf baatne se hi bharta hai. So that takes care of your serotonin hormone. So jab bhi aap apna, matlab Facebook par, ya fir Quora pe, ya WhatsApp pe, ya kahin pe bhi, apna valuable time dekhe, you answer the questions of other people, the problems of other people. That is managing and controlling your serotonin levels. Aapke teen ho gaye pure, you are happy right now. Now the last one is oxytocin. Oxytocin is the hormone of love. So that happens by bonding. You are friends with people. So your best friend, meeting your best friend will increase your oxytocin level. Hugging your parents will increase your oxytocin level. Just holding hands, shaking hands, putting arms around your friends or your family or your little kid or anybody around you, that is controlling your oxytocin level. So these are the four hormones of happiness, and it's in your hand to control your happiness. You cannot blame your happiness on somebody else. You have to make sure that you will be happy by controlling these four things: exercising and starting your day with laughter. So that is endorphins. Second, dopamine. By doing little things so that people start appreciating you. And if people are not appreciating, you ensure that you are appreciating people who are around you. The third is serotonin. Serotonin, by act of giving, little things, sharing knowledge and sharing your things with others. If somebody does not have food with them, you can share your food with that person. So that is serotonin. And fourth is oxytocin, by loving people around you. I hope you'll follow the steps and understand these hormones, all four of them, and control your happiness. Now your happiness is in your hands. Thank you.